Once again, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the third episode of this series. Today, we found an old phone. This is a house phone. This was mostly used for landlines. Now, not a lot of people have landlines because everyone has a cell phone. So what's the need of a landline if you got a cell phone? It's just extra charge. Just to add to that, I want to say that we still have landline just because it's an old number and everyone has it. And that's the reason you can keep yours too. So this, probably we used it at some time, but today we found it and we're going to take it apart. So let's go ahead and show them all the tools we have. Just line them up here so we are ready to this. Pliers.
Two of the same.
Two small screwdrivers, they are the same.
A red screwdriver.
A red screwdriver. By the way, one of these are Phillips, one of these is the flat. And I think, go ahead and bring the other ones.
Two ones
for the same. So the same here, these two are kind of the same, the handle design, these two. But as you can see, we are missing a flat head. See if you can find one. I'll go ahead and get started on this. So, you know, as usual, you're gonna start at the top, the most outer shell. Hopefully, I don't hit my hand again. This happens when you're doing working. Did you find something? Oh, nice. Go ahead now. Oh, man.
Multi-screwdriver.
So this one has another one behind it, and then you open that, and there's another. It goes deep. Anyways, okay, so let's leave that here. He's looking for a flat one because the only one we have is the small one. I think we can still get the job done, but it'd be good to have the other flat ready. Oh, we are getting more. Here we go. This is good. Oh, there we go. Piece of it came off. Look, first piece, it's the cover of the battery. Battery is still intact, but probably is doesn't have charge, and we don't have the base anyway. So let's go ahead and take out the battery. So the battery is DC 2.4 volt. It's very low charge battery, and then it's got a you know, the red and the black ground the wires. Alright, so let's go ahead and the battery, and then we got the phone itself. Let's go ahead and, as you can see, I can see a couple of screws here, and let's go ahead and take those out. So we're going to use the other screwdriver for this. So let's go ahead and open it. There we go, it's coming up. See? Perfect. One. It's still down there somewhere. Here's one more. Some electronics have a lot of screws and things holding it. Sometimes, I think this was the case in older ones, but maybe after year 2000 or longer, or maybe they got the idea from the IKEA. You have just the clips, so you don't have to have a lot of screws. So let's see if we can open this here now, because I don't see any other screws, so we're just gonna push it in the middle. It's gonna open, or it should. Oh, you know what, we need the flat one. Now, did you find a flat?
No, I didn't find it. All I found is this radio shack.
Oh look, it's got
this where it's from Thailand.
Nice. Here's the little clippy thingy for small things. So, all right, so we got the phone, we got it in two pieces now. Look, there's a couple of screws here. I'm gonna go ahead and take those out. The thing about this is we are not gonna break things. That's not taking it apart, because you could break anything and it'll come apart. The way we wanna do it is we wanna open it the way they made it, so.
Yeah.
Now we need the four Phillips one because those are small screws. Let's see here. The one's coming off. Just need a little pressure and finesse. Here's the other one. Yes. This kind of screws, one, two of those. So now there's a plastic here on top of the speaker. See? It's the speaker. Oh, if you put it on speaker like this, then you can hear it. See, there's the other screw. Here's this little, like a clip that was holding this thing down. So, looks like it's held up in a clip or something. So when you're taking things apart, you usually use a flap because it, you know, it goes underneath and you just pop it out. This one, we took the screws out, so it should come off easily, but it looks like it could be clipped or something. So let's see if I can get underneath it or something. Challenging if you don't want to break it. Like this one, I think it's probably used the glue or something because it should just come apart. Oh, there we go. It's out. Just have to get in the right angle. So here's the back cover. It's got that battery location in the back. Then inside of it, you have the speaker, a little filter. And then you have this cover that goes on top of this shell, this motherboard here. So, see, there's another motherboard. We're gonna take this apart and see how it's coming. Looking ahead, there's more two screws. This is nice because every level has some sort of screws to it. Now we need a Phillips here to unscrew this. I don't know if these even sell anymore. Because people are just all used to touch screens. It's really hard to use buttons nowadays, you know. Okay.
So just go ahead and pop.
So we unscrewed two screws from here, one and two, and then we pulled it apart. It's got so many pieces. Look at this, the button, buttons and the torque and all in one plastic piece. So this is the little metal things that maybe not metal, I don't know, is pushing it down to these. So there's that piece, and there's this dialer up and down. Volume, this is the front with the dials and all the buttons and little plastic shield. And look at this is the back, the inside of it that's kind of going over this. There's another speaker, and then there's the mic. So what if we, the mic right here, and the speaker. I wonder if you can use the mic. I don't know. Well, you know what, you could if you had to take it out from back here and weld it, but you need your time. Effort, not worth it. So this must be the processor. I don't think we can get to it without breaking it. I'll try. Yeah, it's stuck pretty much. But you know, we're not in the breaking business. So you can see there's more pieces here. Shit, oh, look at this. Oh man, This is the LCD screen. So this is behind it. I'm sure that each piece of these has a name, but we are not in the business of naming final names right now. So this plastic piece here, there's the dialer, and this is the metal that's making touch with this, this piece of the motherboard right here. All those wires does something, creates a number. So that's down, and we are pulling this out. I think if I pull it up, it's gonna break because it's connected down right below this thing right here. So there's there. I got one microphone for the front, bigger microphone in the back. I wonder if they share the same path. You know, so it's got the connector. So it's a mobile volume. There's this big antenna, very nice. This is probably the main processor. This could be the memory of, I don't know, what kind of buttons. An expert could tell me what these things are. So I want to look at this motherboard and the motherboard we opened from the router. Basically look the same. Technically they work the same way, just transmit ones and zeros and you know, respond to input from, in this case from here, and in this case from here. So we're gonna go and keep this like this, because any more piece will break it. We're gonna keep this next to the other motherboard. These pieces probably can go to trash. I wonder if you can open this and see what's inside of it anyways. It looks like two batteries. So let's just open this. So that's the plastic that's covering this. This is nice. Top section. And we've got the red. On the bottom, both of them are connected. It's going back. And I don't know what there's this wire in the back. Let me see what that is for. Could be ground. Let's take out this plastic here. It's like a. I don't know if it's wire. Yeah, it looks like it. Look. Oh, it's connecting. Like this. Okay, so it's completing the circuit. That's what this thing is doing. So we're gonna take out these little pieces. See that? That's the or the negative of it. Coming from here, switching the battery, then it's coming here and going to the outside. So two of those after circling comes out of here. And same way, it goes back in because you can charge these. So here's almost the naked of these. So any more than this, we'll have to break it apart. I'm sure we can take it apart. So let's see how far we can go without breaking it. If it just comes apart easily by itself, then take it apart. If we have to break something, then. You know, sometimes we have two small pieces just to move the bigger piece, but that's not intentional, that's just necessary. So what about these tapes that are holding this thing together? I bet you there's one more somewhere, and it'll just come apart. There's one piece here. It's a full circuit, very low batteries. Okay, so I think that was another episode of the What's It Now, and I hope you enjoyed.